Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to the SEA League. We are in the semifinals now. It's Neolution Esports going up, Neolution International, rather, going up against Neolution Orange, formerly Orange Esports. They are also sponsored by Neolution. By the way, there's 7 Neolutions in total, so if we get them mixed up here or there, you can probably understand why. I'm LD of Beyond the Summit, and I'm joined here today by Pyrian Flex. How you doing, Pyrian?
I'm fine, dude. That doesn't seem to be going out on the stream.
What doesn't?
What you just said.
There's a 2-minute delay on the stream.
Oh. Okay. Yeah. That's off to a cracking start. Yeah, it's going great, as you can hear.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Oh, dear. So are we going to call these guys, Orange against Neolution Esport International? Do we have to call them that every time we talk about them?
No. I just call them Neo.Int or Neolution, and then Orange, okay. We generally just call Orange. And
okay.
Speaking of Orange, they've picked the PL, the monkey.
Ugh, and this... I hate this guy. A monkey? Is that what you... Well,
That's what Winter
calls... He looks more like a... Really?
Yeah, see, apparently the Chinese call him a monkey, according to Winter. You say he looks like a cat. I think he looks like a little rat man. Like a rat who's learned how to walk on his hind legs.
I can kind of see that. I mean, if you look at, he's kind of got whiskers where a cat would have whiskers, and he's got, his nose is like a cat's, that kind of triangle going down into a mouth like that. That's kind of, kind of looks like a cat to me.
We know one thing for sure, Pyrian, and that's that this hero makes games go longer.
God, yeah, he does. I mean, we had a short delay here at the start, but this game is, I guess he makes them go longer. Maybe they're going to try and push like crazy. I don't know. Who can say? They're going for Luna. Okay, so they've got their long-term carry of their own. Luna's great. I don't know why you don't see her sort of pick more often. I think she's awesome.
Well, the main issue with Luna is just that she's a little bit squishy in the laning stage, and she does need a decent amount of farm. Also, BKBs counter her quite a bit, and we see a lot of heroes that... And obviously, illusion-based heroes, as well as Lone Druid. Sure, her glaives will kill them off, but the problem is that Eclipse damage will mostly be wasted. And that's her primary source of damage in the early game. Yeah, she is very, very popular with certain teams. Like, I don't know if you got to watch the G League, but LGD International would run Luna so many games. It got to a point where they were like 7-0 with her. But they had a whole strategy for the Luna pick. Just picking a Luna, there are carries that go later, so you really want to have a strategy and... It usually involves pushing some early towers.
Right. Yeah, I think that Luna's great. I think that I'd always assumed her Eclipse was to stop her getting like solo ganked. Like when she's in the laner phase or a jungling or something, if someone is dumb enough to try and solo gank her, she just eclipses and melts them.
It is,
right?
It is sort of like the ejector seat, right? If the plane's going down, you press the red button, you're like,
pew! Mash R, and that's that. Yeah.
Of course, a well-executed gank, they'll chain stun her, and she won't have a chance to use Eclipse, or there will be something to tank it, like a mechanism, tanky heroes, illusions, that
sort
of thing.
So with PL, you've got to bring, like, vision and all that kind of stuff. Yeah,
when you're ganky Luna, it's basically proceed with caution. If her ult's down, you'll see most teams, whenever Luna's ult is down, they'll be a lot more aggressive, especially in the early game, because early on, it's got a 3-minute cooldown as long as Enigma's ult, 180 seconds, which is a long freaking time to be without it. Later on, it's not so bad.
Yeah. I mean, I think she's great. I mean, you know... The glaives, and I mean the aura. Her damage passive is awesome. But the glaives, like when you can go up to a quadruple stacked ancients and just melt them and then go and buy an item. It's refreshing as a player who normally doesn't get to do that. So I've had fun playing them.
Pyrian, let me ask you, how much do you love Sand King on a scale of 1 to 5 billion?
5 billion. He's the best. He's ridiculously good hero. He's awesome. He's absolutely awesome because, you know, you've got he's a giant scorpion. I mean, he looks awesome. He has my favorite profile. Look at that big grin and those green eyes. He's so cool. And you could, you know, he's fun to run around little scorpion. On top of which, Burrow is ridiculously good. Sandstorm is pretty good. Of course, the finale is great for farming and pushing and stuff. And his epi is like, you know, can win a team fight. So, yeah, I love him.
Yeah, absolutely. I also want to point out with the draft that we saw something very unusual from Neolution International, which was 2 respect bans. They banned the Bounty Hunter, which is pretty much the only offlaner we've really seen KY XY play a lot. We used to see him play solo mid for Orange, usually when Mushi or Yamate wasn't playing. He's now in that three role, which means he goes to the offlane, something you were doing for us at the Staff Cup. But the Bounty Hunter gets banned, and also the Rubick. This is a huge respect ban, mostly targeted towards Extinct, although Net has played it on occasion. I haven't seen him play it as of late for Orange. But these two, normally not heroes we see banned in the first two, and that just tells you how much Neolution International respects those two particular players. In KYXY's case, I think it's more that he's a limited hero pool, at least that Orange has run a lot. And in Extinct's case, it's he's just a freaking ridiculous Rubick.
Yeah, I was kind of surprised to see Rubick first ban. I mean, he's an awesome hero. I've played him a few times, and he's great fun. I mean, you know, he is great fun to play against. That's for sure. Respect ban, first ban. Yeah, that is kind of a surprise.
Like, you know, Darkseer, you're good at a hero?
Not banned. Fourth ban for the top guy as Darkseer. And Tinker, you know, I don't often see Tinker banned. That's kind of a surprise, I guess.
Well,
he's awesome.
With Neolution, they already have the Luna who can push very hard. So Luna's going to be pressuring one lane, and the problem is if you give up Tinker and the enemy team already has Nyx Assassin, these two heroes can just show up out of nowhere, right? Because you never know where Nyx is. He's always in Viz, and then Tinker can be anywhere once he gets his boots of travel. If you want to go global strategy or even just aggressive ganking, this creates a lot of space for the Luna. So yeah, I think the Tinker ban's actually quite smart.
Smart ban, yeah. I mean, you could stick a Lifestealer in someone and have him. I love that. When there's a fight and you think, oh, we can take him, and then suddenly Lifestealer pops out of somebody. There's nothing else quite like it.
There's
Jakira, the top team, Orange have picked Magnus, Sank, and Jakira, three of my favorite heroes, and then one of my most hated heroes in Phantom Lancer. So, they've won me over.
Yeah, and speaking of the Taker, it's also a great way to counter the split push of a Phantom Lancer. So on multiple fronts, it's a good choice. And we'll have to see what Neolution goes for. They need that third component for the tri-lane. We'd be thinking something like a Lina. In fact, I'd say it's almost required for them because they don't have... Actually, I guess I'm not sure if they're going to run the Nyx Assassin mid is the main thing. Mm. It could be Nyx.
What about Venge? Venge is always. I was reading a thing about how Venge is good, like start to finish. If it's going to be a long game, would she be a good pick?
No, not really in this case. I mean, it's either a solo mid Nyx, in which case you really want an AoE stun to combo with disruption, like a Lina, Lightstrike, right? Or it's going to be a support Nyx, in which case they want another solo. And I'm not sure who that solo is going to be. Lifestealer can solo 1v1 versus Mag, so can Luna reasonably well. So I'm guessing it'll be an offensive tri-lane with the Lifestealer Shadow Demon plus one, the Luna 1v1 in the safe lane versus Magnus, and then we'll have to see who that third hero is.
5 seconds remain.
And it will be an Ancient Apparition, so they may actually do some dual lanes. We could see... We have seen some teams throw Lifestealer into the suicide lane by himself. But up against Neolution's lineup, I mean, he's not going to get a whole lot of experience. He won't die, per se. So we'll see what they do. Most likely, I guess it's going to be... Actually, this is a very interesting draft. It could. I'm still thinking most likely it'll be the offensive tri-lane, and then...
10 seconds.
I think we'll actually see a Nyx mid and a Luna safe lane. That looks like the most viable way to run the lineup.
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, I think it's tough. With heroes who need a lot of farm and don't have an escape like Luna, it's tough to stick her on her own, even in the safe lane. You know, I don't know. It always seems like a kind of a risk to me if you're relying on that person to get a buttload of farm and then you basically say, well... We'll be top. See you later. It's kind of
Some carry heroes can do that, like an anti-mage, because they man up against almost everyone and they could just zone them out of the lane. But Luna can't really do that. Generally, what you'll see teams do if she gets the safe lane farm is they'll pull her a little bit of regen, like they'll buy her an extra set of tangos or a salve. And sometimes maybe we'll see a smoke gank or some roaming. That's the other possibility is with Shadow Demon and Ancient Apparition, you can roam these two heroes quite a bit. We could even see a solo mid AA if they wanted to do that. He's just not normally gone. You don't normally put a mid because he's not particularly. He doesn't scale as well as some other heroes. So if you give a hero mid farm, you really want them to offer a lot to your team. But it's something Na'Vi used to do back at the International. And they could throw the AA mid. You get that early level 6 Ice Blast. And with the Nyx Assassin, I mean, it's that assassination potential. It's just all of a sudden, out of nowhere, a wild Nyx appears, an Ice Blast appears, and you're dead.
Yeah, he's a terrifying hero. He's genuinely terrifying. Crazy burst damage and invisible. What are you going to do? Weaver. Ugh. I hate Weaver and I hate PL.
And it's going to be a KYXY Magnus, which leaves the Weaver for Mushi. Interesting. Mushi's been going mid. I want to say... I assume it's KYXY in the offlane. Mushi might be going mid as Weaver.
Mm.
He's not really a very strong mid.
10 seconds remaining.
Generally. We could see KYXY rotate to the mid lane. You can run an offensive trilane with the Weaver, which is actually pretty potent. And PL, if they're expecting that offlane to just be one hero, he should be fine against any of Neolution's heroes 1v1. Maybe they
thought Weaver can go mid because...
Oh, no, like, they switched the heroes. Okay, they're playing mind games with us.
Ah, okay. Because I was going to say, because, like, Neo.Int, they haven't got, like, a quap or some nightmarish mid that you want to go mega strong against. Maybe Weaver could... They thought Weaver could do okay against any of the guys they put mid.
Well, quickly, period, we should introduce the players on the side of Neolution.Orange. We have KYXY on the offlane Weaver, which is what makes the most sense. Mushi on the solo mid mag. Normally, he'd be playing that one position with the new lineup, but Ohio is not here. You may remember him as that Dagon 5 Aetheroblade Tinker. I think you might have watched that game. We have Net on the support, Jakiro, so not really a playmaking support. Kachik Imba, the stand-in, going to be playing the Phantom Lancer. And last but not least, it's Extinct on the Sand King.
Okay, and for Neo.Int, we're going to call him Neo.Int?
Neo.Int is great.
Okay, we got Boogie USAP.
That's Ninja Boogie.
Ninja Boogie on the Luna. Hachiko on the Ancient Apparition. Blah on the Assassin. Lay on Lifestealer and Fox on Shadow Demon.
Yeah, we know it's going to be solo mid Nyx. He's rushing a bottle, and it's Blah, who has been playing solo mid for them. So they're going to offensive trialing with Shadow Demon, Lifestealer, and Ancient Apparition, which is actually... They don't have a real stun, but what they do have is a guaranteed cold feet between disruption as well as open wounds. You're always gonna be able to get that cold feet off, unless a hero has, say, a blink escape, which in this case nobody does. So they may be able to set up some early kills, double damage up on KYXY.
Yeah, the Weaver's gravity just chased Luna back to her tower, took her down to about 2/3 health. Was no fun.
This is gonna be very hard for the Luna now because he's also got 6 tangos, whereas for Ninja Boogie. He needs to get the Tranquil Boots up. Weaver is a great harassment here on the laning stage. So this is, you know, when we see LGD International run the solo Luna, it's normally against a hero that the Luna has a little bit of an easier time with. Like, we saw it versus Nature's Prophet in one game, I think. In this particular case, this is a tough matchup.
Yeah. Yeah, laning against Weavers. That ain't no fun. By the way, I was surprised. There were heroes that I've always assumed were, like, auto-picks. And certainly when I play, people are always rushing to get him. Undying, was he banned? Or is he not popular? Or
I don't remember if he's banned in this game. He's not super popular in Southeast Asia. The Pinoy teams like him a bit more because they love to offensive tri-lane and go for a lot of early kills. But that's a hero that's really famous or really popular in Europe.
Yeah, he is, yeah. I mean, you know, it's any sort of European game, Undying is either picked or banned as early as possible because he's so crazy.
Well, especially because a lot of the European teams nowadays are going for the offensive tri-lanes and they're running 2 solos, or they're even doing, you know, say 2 heroes in the offlane. But Undying just gives you, and if you're up against an offensive tri-lane as well, Undying just gives you such a ridiculously hard to kill lane between the Soul Rip and the Decay. You can't go on him, but you can't ignore him. It's a lose-lose, pretty much.
My favorite lane at the moment to run is Kotl Undying. You see it a lot, and it's horrible, horrible for the other team. So I like to run that lane.
Wow, this Luna rather.
Luna, she's having no fun.
This could be a dive attempt for the first blood. The first Sakuchi does miss, though. I don't know if he can find the kill. He's gonna go for the auto text. There is no salve. If Boogie had a healing salve, most likely KOX would not be diving like this. He's thinking about it.
Oh, the loosened beam just lets him get away. That was nice.
I was holding my breath.
75 health. I think this Weaver. Oh, there's another one to follow up. I think this Weaver could. Well, he's gonna kill us soon, surely.
Oh, top lane. Yeah. Uh oh. Lay's trying to bait up the Burrow Strike. Maybe he doesn't want to though. Here comes the mag as well. That's a haste on Mushi. Oh boy.
Ice Bath catches Lifestealer. He's in big trouble. Magnus dived so far!
Magnus
is the first one that's gonna get away! He's dead. He's a dead man!
Well, they get the first blood, and they get the enemy carry, so it makes it a good trade. At the same time, though, that's your solo mid who died. That is a lot of experience. And Blah is free farming.
So Weaver's gonna finish off Luna down bot here, so Weaver managed to pick her up. Pick up the second kill there. That was nifty. She was so low. She was like 100 health, and she was just sort of just the other side of the creep wave. He's so speedy when he hits that Shikuchi, caught her up and killed her, no problem.
Apparently I spelled your name wrong in the overlay, Pyrian. I hope you forgive me. But it is Pyrian Flex, not Pyian Flex.
Who's Pyian Flex? Dang.
Oh, jeez.
It's alright. I can live with it.
So the offlane Weaver is dominating this lane now. This is a safe lane Luna. You run her safe lane to get a quick level 6 to get even level 7, and then you can start joining your team for some early pushes, constantly putting pressure on the lane. You don't run the safe lane Luna to lose the lane and give up what would have been a first blood if Mushi hadn't gone top.
Yeah,
that's
to
trouble.
Weaver. Yeah, horrible.
And Weaver is one of these heroes that he's strongest in the laning stage, generally, and the reason that he could be good later on is because he gets ahead. So
right. The
fact that he's had a good start is trouble for Neolution.
Yeah. She's how's she doing the last hit? She's 9-5, okay. He is 13-7. There's not a huge amount in it. But if you expand that out over, say, 20 minutes, I guess that's going to be a big difference.
I got to point out, once again, the good movement from the Neolution, the orange supports, they're very good about this. They've dewarded everything, and they have a lane ward up. And when you're offensive tri-laning, you want to have vision, because you want to know if they're pulling, you want to be able to ideally jack the pulls, or gank their supports when they're sitting in the trees, or at least see the ganks coming. And right now, they are playing almost entirely in the dark. They just have the rune ward.
Yeah, lane wards, I mean, you know, I don't know why it seems to be, even at the level I'm playing at, it seems to be all about the tri-lane at the moment. Like, everybody's like, right, we'll have solo mid, solo off, and then, you know, when I used to play, it always used to be 2-2-1, but now it seems to be like 1-1-3. And with the lane wards are absolutely huge, especially if you've got someone like Kotl on either team. You get a good lane ward, it makes it so much easier. Obviously, they don't have a Kotl, but... Oh, here goes the lifestealer in on the Sand King. Sandstorm to get out of it. There's the Burrow Strike on Ancient Apparition. Ice Bath comes in. I think he's gonna get away. Nope, he's gonna die! He's gonna die! Poor Sand King. Oh man, I hate to see that.
Uh-oh, Jakiro is running right into that angry ghoul. This is not good.
He looks more like a monkey to me, lifestealer. Look at the way he walks.
That's a zombie monkey.
Oh, the escape Ice Bath. Who's this TPing in? Are they gonna turn it around?
Oh, he needs to be south.
Sand King back for more.
Hachiko! No, they're not going to even go for him!
They're going to kill Shadow Demon.
He doesn't have mana for TP, he's trying to steal his branches!
Finishes off the Jakiro! It's horrible, it's like watching all my friends get murdered! It's horrible!
It's a bloodbath! Yeah, these are all your favorite heroes and they're all dying!
They're still dying! No!
Oh, bottom lane. Oh, KYXY, he doesn't have mana for another Sakuchi! If Ninja Boogie knew that, he may have been able to kill him off, but it looks like he doesn't. Then he runs back out, tanks the Lucian Beam.
Yeah.
Also,
It was interesting, but Boogie, there, he just sort of used the Lucian Beam and then ran away. I've always thought, you know, I have always been told, you Lucian Beam and at least get an auto-attack in there as well, sort of thing. But he died to him already. It's been tough in the lane. He might be a little tremulous, shall we say.
Yeah, he's...
Haste Rune, grab the Haste Rune here. He's going to come back and maybe mess with Luna a bit more.
I mean, it's basically like you said. He gave up a kill early, and now he's just playing defensively. Because the lifesteal already died. Sure, he's got phase boots. He's farming okay. But you're up against a much better late-game lineup with Phantom Lancer, Mag, and Weaver. Neolution is international. Is not going to win this late unless they can start creating kills. Split pushing effectively. Oh, they're going to go on mid. Mushi, it is nighttime. So he did not see this one coming. And there will be a Nyx Assassin stun. He can't skewer away. Mushi is dead.
Oh, poor Mushi.
That's some hate on
Mushi.
I mean,
what can you do? I mean, you know, what can you do? If guys are coming around the back and they don't see him, you know, what can you do? As a Magnus, he could have skewered out, I guess, but that's why Shadow Demon is so awesome. You get disrupted, that's it. Everybody gets in position around you, you're screwed.
Yeah, I do want to point out as well that they placed a new Observer Ward at the top rune, but it was right after the gank came in. Because normally when you're up against an offensive tri-lane, it's kind of hard to get to the rune to ward it safely. You often see newer supports just feeding, trying to get there. So, Orange did get the fresh ward up, but they were a little bit late to do it, because right around that 6-minute mark is when the ward normally expires, and that's why Mushi got ganked.
Mushi's just going to finish off this Nyx here. That was a nice skewer. He just got around the other side of him, just sort of nudged around, skewered him back towards the tower. Tower got him down with a couple of hits, and then he finished off with the shockwave. That was nice.
He did use an RP just for that solo kill, which is still worth it by all means, but it does mean that Neolution International could be a little bit more comfortable now. They know that the RP is on cooldown. Whenever a spell like RP is up, you do not want to tower dive, you do not want to be aggressive, but with it down, they have a little more, well, freedom to move, basically.
I guess, but I mean, when they ganked him up, wasn't RP up when they ganked him?
Yeah, well, he was chain stunned. He never got to use it. Right as the disruption ended, he got... he's cold-feeded, and then he was impaled. He couldn't use it. He had like his arms tied behind his legs, and then like wrapped around his head, and all. He's a contortionist, except not by choice.
Indeed.
And Mushi is gonna pick up a double damage rune. I would like to see him go for a gank on this Luna bottom lane. But he's not gonna. That's something that we'd see Xiaowei do a lot.
Luna's there for the killing. I mean, she's, you know, yeah, she's there. There's all this focus. I think the problem is when you've got the tri lane, not the problem, but sort of the tendency, is that everybody focuses on the tri lane. Like, all the fights, everything seems to be going on there because it's like, I guess it's more fun. You want to pile in there, join in the melee.
I mean, Weaver is winning his lane, so it's not like they need a gank here. It's just that they could find one. And even. Yeah. Oh, the action's going to break out.
They're going to go on the Shadow Demon here. He's in a world of hurt. In goes Sand King. Ice Path to follow up. Shadow Demon manages to get a disrupt on himself. Is he going to get away? Lifestealer coming in with the blocks. Phantom Lancer can't chase him. Shadow Demon manages to get back to his tower. Lifestealer going in on the Sand King. Sand King's got a burrow. He's got a Sandstorm. Is he saving him up? Yeah, he doesn't need a burrow.
That was a nice. He was actually baiting that. He was hoping Lei would dive him a bit more.
Pop a salve, Sandstorm if you get in big trouble, no problema.
I also want to point out there was a Sentry Ward top, and they were able to spot that Nyx coming in, so they were pretty prepared for it overall.
It's, I mean, you know, these guys know exactly where.
Yeah, if you're up against Nyx, you need Sentry Wards in the lane, ideally in every lane, but at least in the lane where most of your heroes are.
Yeah, exactly. Although, They have actually no vision in their jungle here, down here where the Luna's trying to farm. If you look at the where all the wards are top, all it would take would be someone to mosey through this jungle. They could get right up on top of her, and Luna's there for the taking.
The Luna, and that's why Ninja Boogie's playing so defensively. You'll notice whenever he doesn't see the enemy supports, he's just forced to sit back in his tower. Whenever he doesn't see the mag, he's forced to. Oh, Mushi! He's looking for the shockwave.
Oh wow, Nyx Assassin down to 30 health. There's a regen.
Yeah.
And that's nice. He put a shockwave towards a regen in case Nyx was going for it. That was a nice move.
Yeah, that was quite clever actually. Uh-oh, Boogie's out of mana, but he does have wand. His stick charges. He could eclipse.
He's got a. Well, all right. Well, that was.
That was anticlimactic.
The same total lack of health. There goes Illusion Beam. Shikuchi to follow up. Oh, he just managed to get up with 100 health left.
Meanwhile, top lane, Net's in trouble. Net will fall. Kachik Emba forced the TP out. The Nyx Assassin strikes, and they do have the Sentry Ward over in the lane, but they did not have anything behind the tower. And the Nyx Assassin, actually, if you recall, he just was busy almost getting killed by Mushi, and now he's up top killing off a support. They were not prepared for that. I'm sure, most likely what happened is Mushi said, oh hey, Nyx is going back to base, and then he wasn't back to base, he was actually
getting killed. Look at this, Mitch, you got Magnus and Sand King chasing down Nyx. I think he's gonna get away, they have to pull back, but yeah, they're all over each other's jungles at the moment. It's hard to tell where the attack is going to be coming from. Sort of poking at each other as well. Look at this, Shadow Demon and AA, anytime anyone goes to try and pull the lane, they're right up in their faces.
And Lei is the one who's really up in your face, crawling around, stealing the neutrals.
He's terrifying. Lifesteal is a terrifying guy to go up against.
Yeah, he's a pretty ugly one, too.
Sekiro just lurking around here in the bushes.
Mushi's lurking. He's got his RP.
He's got RP, they've got Ice Path as well, could set it up with the Ice Path. There it goes, manages to catch Lifestealer, in comes the Skewer, RP catches Lifestealer, PL gonna come in. He's jumped inside a creep. Where'd he go?
Fox thought that he needed to disrupt him there, but it actually looked like he's gonna be okay. Oh, Harshino!
Track. Okay, now he's back. Oh my goodness, that was insane. Who died? Magnus and Magnus thought we missed a Luna killing off Weaver bot. He's under
attack. And there goes Sank. Nyx
has caught him. The creeps might finish him off. No, they managed to get him as well. Gosh, there's three dead.
This is a bloodbath. 15 kills at 12 and a half minutes in, and it feels like even more than that. And Mushi dying there is a big, because he's getting very close to his Blink Dagger, but it's now delayed. And that Blink RP, that Blink Skewer even, is so huge. Just even when your RP's down, you can set up a kill just by blinking and skewer them back. But with that down,
he killed Nyx mid just by walking up to him and skewering him back towards the tower. So think what he can do with a Blink Dagger and Skewer.
Yeah, you can't underestimate him. Oh, Haste up on Blah. This should be very big. You'll notice he always has a TP scroll, as does Mushi, because these two, they're the ones who basically choose when the teams fight. The Chikimbo. Again, dying. As badly as the Luna's doing, the PL is doing even worse.
Yeah, he is having no fun up here. It's tough. I mean, it's tough to get, like, in an aggressive trialing like that, it is tough to get good farm. You know, you've got two good supports in AA and Shadow Demon backing up Lifestealer who can get right up in your grill. It's tough. I mean, he's got Sand King, Jakiro, who are... I mean, obviously, if you go, like, more of a kind of support role, Sand King, he's awesome.
Nick's on a plane!
Nick's on a plane!
I just really wanted to say that, but Net's gonna drop that haste rune from the Nick's. They didn't spot him coming up top. Disruption now, locking Extinct in position, and then he's brought down by the Impale. Neolution, this is what they needed to do, Pyrian, is just start finding those kills, don't let the PL sit back and farm. And yep. Mushi was not there for the fight. I think his RP just cooled down, but by the time he could have gotten it anyway, the fight wasn't really going to be something that he could get to quickly enough.
Yeah, it's tough without the follow-up. It's not something he really wants to go in on. Meanwhile, but how is Luna doing? She's 50-12 up against Weaver 68-28. He is he's getting some awesome denies in there. What about items? How's she doing? Oh well, yeah. Compare that to the Magnus, who's almost on. He's about to get his Blink Dagger. So yeah, she's not doing great.
Yeah, the two solos for Orange are dominating overall when it comes to farm, which is pretty standard for Mushi, certainly. Even when he's that sort of initiator like Mag, he's gonna focus on his farm.
They want to get this mid tower down to 62 health. Magnus is just going to finish off. Can he get the deny in from Nyx?
Outplayed!
Nice! That was nice.
Mushi, I think he thought he would have enough damage to bring it down, but he's just slightly off. He needed to juke that impale.
The stun deny, that was a nice move. I mean, if he juked the impale, he's not going to get the last hit on it anyway, so...
Well, yeah, I guess he really would need a Quelling Blade there or something like that. You could try and skewer away from the impale, but still stay near the tower. So they smoke towards mid. The gank's not going to catch them in the end. They couldn't get in range for a disruption. I also want to point out, whenever this tier 1 falls in the enemy safe lane, like the top tower, and you're running an offensive trialing with a survivable hero like Lifestealer, then you can easily go and set up ganks mid, leave the Lifestealer to farm top. Meanwhile, there's going to be a gank attempt on the bottom lane, I believe.
Yeah, this is interesting. Mushi seems to have...
Look at all the sentry wards.
He's grabbed an invis rune and just moseying around here, getting an eyeball on things, having a look what's going on. Coming around the back here, Jakiro and Sanka, they're going to try and set up a gank. They've got two squishy supports to catch here.
Oh,
invis is halfway done.
Oh, he wants it!
Do they sense something? No, there's the RP. Skewers the AE towards his pals, so there's the finishing move from Magnus Oxpath as well, just to rub it in.
Oh, Mushi was just a little impatient there. If he had made sure to skewer both, that would have easily been a double kill. Not really. The RP was perfect, but he just needed to move slightly around to make sure he caught both in the skewer. Still, they get the kill.
It was a beautiful setup. It really was. I like that. It was nice. A nice use of
it. Reminds me.
Use it to fill up a bottle. He's got his Blink Dagger now as well. So.
Yeah, and now he could keep on doing that Blink Skewer combo. It really reminds me of one of those nature films where you're watching like the cheetah stalk the antelope, just waiting for it to pounce. And then there's the epic...
trouble here. Look at this. You've got Sand King and Jakiro. These guys are just not going to let up. They're going to do the roaming sort of supporty gank squad. I'm going to try and catch this Lifestealer out. As you said, he is a tough dude to catch. Incredibly tough and a good escape. So.
They actually should not be able to kill him, I don't think. And they don't have Epicenter yet. The only way you can kill the Lifestealer without the Magnus is if you chain stun him. He can never rage or infest.
Yeah.
But they don't have the Epicenter. To burst him down while he's chain stunned. So
actually, Sand King has just hit level 6. As you say that, he has literally just got Epi. So they could do something here. But,
it's very risky. And then if you waste your Epi, then you don't have it for all the other fights where the much squishier supports are.
Yeah.
Also, want to point out more sentry wards. And this is actually a very clever one because I think it gives you true sight just pretty much all through the lane and all through the jungle right here. So you can pretty much see the Nyx coming anywhere.
It's one of those nifty spots. They're always interesting to me. You find those spots, and that's a good one. I'll try using that myself.
That's like somehow squeezing your car into a spot that like clearly looks too small, but you know you finagle it in. You basically ram the. You're trying to parallel park. You ram the one guy in front and the one guy behind a lot.
Weaver getting eclipsed down there by Luna. How's she doing down here now? She's 69-13. Yeah, maybe she's starting to pick up a bit. DD Magnus coming in, that's a reason. That'll give you pause. Loosen beam on him. Are they going to go after him?
They can't go on this Mag. He's got RP. The tower's still up. But top lane they can go.
I think they're gonna go on him. They got Luna and Nyx. There goes the Lucent Beam. Oh, but he can skewer away. There's no follow-up. He's gonna grab this Invis rune as well. Wow, they were very close. I think if they got, they couldn't get round to him, but
The chase continues. Top. While that was happening, there was actually a couple of kills, and the Ice Pad just gonna miss the support that was TPing back to base. HM Prashad a gem. That would have been a huge kill on Harchiko, but he just escapes. Barely at that. And that Ice Path, it's very strong in some sense, but it does have that annoying time that you have to cast it for. Oh, Weaver's diving. He knows Eclipse is down. This is what I was talking about with the aggression. When Eclipse is down, you can really dive.
Yeah, 101 seconds left. I mean, yeah, you're right. That's a crazy long cooldown. Mid is getting pushed down here by Lifesteal.
Oh, sorry, did I say 180 earlier? I guess I was slightly off. But yeah, 160. I mean, it's almost as long as a black hole at level 1.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's crazy.
It does do a freaking ton of damage.
let's not cry too much about the long cooldown on Eclipse, because it is ridiculous.
No, let's cry, please.
Okay. Even in late game, it's, you know, you're looking at, what is it, 1,000, some 1,100 damage it can do? It's, 10 beams each doing 300 damage? It's ridiculous, right? So,
Oh, the Weaver gets the Sakuja out, but there's dust here, and I think they can, no, they can't burst him down. Oh, boy.
He's such a butthole. I hate Weaver, just when you think you got him as well. This could be a big fight bot. These AA and Shadow Demon, this is not where you want to be in the river here. Get out of there. They're TP in top. I guess they're going to try and mess with PL a bit. But yeah, I hate that. When you're caught in this area here in the middle of the river is a horrible area to be.
Yeah, Orange has picked a lineup that's very hard to deal with because the Weaver had a good start. You need to shut down PL. You have to constantly keep pressure in his lane. That's why we saw three supports up there for the first 15, 18 minutes. But the problem is, the Weaver's getting free farm and your Luna needs help. So as we see the Nyx rotate down bottom, hey, free farm for PL. And he's starting to really catch up now. He's still quite behind enemy carries, but remember, this is PL. He doesn't need his maps to be effective, PL. And once he gets big enough, he'll be unstoppable.
And he can farm everything all at once, it seems. So yeah, if he starts running away with it, he's genuinely scary in one of the ways that very few heroes are, I think. Farmed up PL is like a crazy farmed up anti-mage or something. You just feel helpless at that point.
I want to see like a parody of the micro skills video with PL skills where it's just every time you up RP bottom lane.
RP's Q on Luna. Burrow Strike to follow up. She is dead as a doornail. Oh, but there's a disruption. The FP's completely wasted. In comes Nyx. Gets the stun on Shadow Demon. They finish him off. Luna goes down as well. Lifestealer coming in and chasing down on the Magnus. I think they're going to catch him. Stun coming in from Nyx. Nope. Lay manages to finish him off anyway. Weaver scuttling away like an invisible maggot. And what's happening mid here? Well, Jakiro's just busy doing his thing.
Yeah, that was Net did not have a TP there. You would really like to have your Jakiro doesn't need to be farming right now. You'd really like to have him in that fight while the PL's pushing.
Ice Path there could have definitely saved. Disruption is so great for both saving friends and setting up enemies. I love it. I mean, I've never played Shadow Demon, but I'm sure I'd enjoy it. I've never played Kotl, but I love Kotl now. He's amazing.
Disruption is also great for trolling your team as well. If you ever just want to piss someone off or mess around with your buddy.
Yeah, it's one of those few spells like Tiny's Toss. It's one of those few spells that you can actually cast on an ally whether they want it or not. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I can't mana leak a friend even as much as I want to, but I could disrupt them.
Yeah, especially, or disrupt the enemy like right when he's about to die, and then suddenly the backup comes and your friend doesn't get the kill and your friend dies. That might have just happened to me yesterday.
Oh man. So Luna has switched to top now. I guess she's gonna farm a lane while PL farms the jungle. What's happening here down to AA?
Wow. Lifestone has actually completed his Mjolnir.
Well,
I imagine he's gonna disassemble this and make an assault cuirass, I want to say, but I don't know about this choice. I feel like you really want that Desolator or the Basher. The Basher, because you want to be able to just burst a hero down while you're in rage form. If you don't get caught by RP, and the Desolator because it's just another way to get amazing burst damage. But the Mjolnir is great at killing illusions, but you don't want this to go late anyway. Because if this goes late, then PL's fat, and eventually Lifesteal can't deal with him if they're even remotely similar farm. If it goes like that 35, 40 minute mark. So I'm not sure about this Mjolnir choice. I feel like there are better options this game.
Yeah, it's tough if PL goes goes late. What kind of AoE like burst You know what I mean? Like with Jakiro, you could.
They don't have much actually. Kind of,
yeah, they haven't got anything really. So it's a tough one. The later this goes, even though they're looking good now, I think they're aware of that. They've been very aggressive from the get go. I think they're fully aware that they need to win this. But PL didn't have much good farm in the early game, but as you said, you know, he can snowball. But I don't know. I think they'll start pushing like crazy now. Luna's got her BKB. They've put her top to just try and get some farm, and I think the rest are going to keep pushing towers and keeping the other team occupied. They also need to keep pressure on this Weaver, and I think they're aware of that, because you don't want him getting farmed up either.
Yeah, PL's still getting farmed top. They have not come after him in a while, and he is behind the Luna, but only slightly, and they're not pressuring him. The Nyx Assassin has not been active around the map, and this is a credit to the support. Sentry wards placed in the lanes. The PL, of course, very, very difficult to gank. The thing is, he's so far away from his tier 1, from the rest of the action because his tier 1 died early. Normally when you see teams push one tower, they try and get two in the enemy safe lane, because otherwise it just means the enemy carry gets to farm closer to his own base. And yeah, you can see the map being drawn out by the support Harchiko. They're farming here, guys. Let's do something about it. But it's hard to do it. And they really need to go for a smoke gank. Maybe get a gem up on one of the supports. Or use that gem a little bit more actively, rather.
This smoke gank might run into an invisible Magnus here.
Oh.
So I'm not quite sure what would happen there. But this Magnus has been loitering around here. Mushi's been loitering around here for a little while. I mean, they're obviously trying to set up a fight. This is that point in the game, around the 20-minute and the 30-minute mark, it always seems to me. Around the 20-minute mark, you get a big fight, and around the 30-minute mark, you get a big fight. I don't know why, just always seems to go that way.
Well, this game, Orange will be happy if there's no fights for the next 30 minutes, because then they'll be in good shape.
Yeah, they're blocked
with the Blake Dagger on the Nyx.
Oi, oi, oi. Follow-up skewers out of there. Zankin can come in with a bar, but he doesn't want to go in while Karampus is up. No, that's that. I think they're just going to pick off the mag and then try and push a little bit. Without that RP, they feel a little bit freed up. 40 seconds he's down for. I guess they're going to try and push this tier 2.
Kachikimba under a lot of pressure now, though. If the Luna gets a lucid beam and there's a Nyx here, which there is!
Nice. Oh, wow, yeah. I mean, that's the lucid beam. It's only a short stun, but it's sometimes it's all you need. And Nyx, of course, running top as fast as his many legs would carry him and got the finishing blow. That was nice.
Blah, blah, I have to say, is carrying this game right now for Neolution. He is playing exceptionally well. And this is why most teams will not give up Nyx Assassin no matter what.
He's so powerful. I mean, you know, he's a great hero. He's strong. You can mid him if you need to. And once he gets up those levels, he's scary. Amazing burst damage. And he can end a good escape with the invis. He's awesome. Nyx is a great hero. I'm terrible at him, but he is very, very good. I honestly think I played the worst Nyx in history the other day. It was, oh my god, my team was so disappointed. What can you do?
I actually highly doubt that. Because because I don't, it's not possible, given some of the games that you'll see if you ever make a new account.
That's true. I do, oddly enough, because of the IQ with people who are like your good self, who are sort of high and very high and stuff, I tend not to run into terrible players as often as I'd like to.
It's true, though. Sometimes you just want to have a fun, easy game.
Yeah. It is nice when you get those fun, easy games.
This is not an easy game for Orange, though. That much is clear. They're on the defensive. Mushi looks to be going for a 4-staff after his blink, which just allows him to be more aggressive with finding the openings for his blink skewer, because now it's a blink 4-staff skewer combo. PL finally completes that defusal blade. Man, that's such a late defusal.
Yeah.
And the Weaver went for Lincoln's, but there's quite a few ways to remove this. I'm not convinced it's going to be the save all. I gotta go back to the Nyx Assassin. Getting the early gem and the Blink Dagger for this particular hero is so powerful. It was actually purchased by the support Harchiko, as you would expect, but that Blink Nyx, look how restricted Orange are now. They're afraid to farm almost anywhere.
I'm just watching Lifestealer with the Mjolnir up, just electrifying all the illusions and everything around him, I think. But he's just gone up there to counter push PL because PL was in danger of taking down this tower, I think. I'm not quite sure. Well, I guess are they dewarding? No? You said someone had a gem. Who had the gem?
The Nyx, and he still has it. And now he's got a dag on one.
Yeah, he's got dag on one, so okay. Because he needs a bit more burst damage, right?
even a tanky support like a Jakiro is food for this Nyx. If he gets caught at all, he's dead. If anybody gets caught and there's a follow-up of any kind, well, almost any kind, like, say, the Shadow Demon, maybe the Luna, then that hero's dead, too. And Luna's getting closer and closer to her Manta style, so everything is really looking good for Neolution. And sure, PL's the harder carry, but if you're getting out-pushed and out-farmed like this, multiple carries can deal with the PL. Nakes is not really the best one to do it, generally. You prefer to have something like a Gyro if the game goes really late, but... Oh, here we go, bottom.
There's the FB. Oh, she BKB's just in time, so dodges it all. Oh, and she's gonna finish off Sand King. Oh, that was brutal!
That BKB.
God, they thought they had it. It was perfect time just before the ice path could hit. Maybe there was a half a second, if that. Just managed to get a BKB off. Epi does bugger all, and she survives the gank. I don't know if you saw top, but Nakes was getting pushed back by PL and Weaver. Weaver chased him from, well, where their tier 2 was, all the way back to the the Radiant T1.
Okay, why XY, he is going to get caught and melted, and Neolution, all of a sudden, Neolution International is going to get the tier 2 bottom. RP's available, so they will be able to defend, but that BKB going off by Luna, I mean, Mag just wasn't able to get the RP out in time, and that might cost them racks, in fact. Well, they might be able to defend this, but they're missing the Weaver, who's an important hero at this point. They're gonna lose a lot of damage. Oh, that's unfortunate. Luna dies top of the PL.
Ouch.
Tried to TP and defend, but was a little bit too low. Here comes the Nyx. Oh.
Yeah, there's the RP, just catches Shadow Demon. Lifestealer coming to Ice Path. He's immune. Are they going to get Shadow Demon? Disrupts himself? Well, he's just delaying the inevitable. Skewered. He's a dead man.
I want to point out, Blah blinked out of that. He didn't get caught by the RP. This guy, man. This guy is having the game of his life. Such impressive play from Blah. He is really controlling the game for this team. But that was an overextension. As soon as the mag respawns, you have to back up.
Yeah, Orange finally managed to take a tower. The Neo.Int have lost their tier 1 top. But yeah, they were in danger of losing racks, all because of that team fight that went wrong when they left Sand King and Magnus in the one fight. It was just like you were saying,
I think because the Luna is BKB and Eclipse, it was probably a mistake to actually commit to that. That's why she TP'd out top, but the problem was that her team just got greedy. They thought they could pick up the support. They were emboldened by the Nyx Assassin finding all those solo kills, and they were just short of killing the Jakiro. Then the mag all of a sudden is alive, but you have to be disciplined in that situation. You have to know the mag's going to come back, he's got RP, and you've just got to be a little bit more careful. So... in retrospect, you know, they were not in a position, given the situation, to actually go for racks, but what they could have done is just force the PL to come back and defend and then back off, and that would have been a victory in and of itself.
Right.
So, a bit of a blunder there, and he's upgrading the Dagon, level 2.
Dang. Dag nabbit! The Dagon is something, I've never got it to level 5, but I think I've got it to level... got a level 2 or 3. It is great fun, but you kind of feel invincible when you've got it, you know?
Yeah, and it's also...
you kind of think, I can kill everything now.
It's really effective when your team's ahead, not just because the enemy supports are squishy, but think about it this way. They don't have their towers up, so they need more wards than they normally would, because they don't have the vision from the towers, they don't have the map control from them. So they need extra wards, they need advanced warding, which means you don't have tower gold on your team, or not as much anyway, and you're forced to buy extra wards, and you're worried about this Nyx burst you down, so you may even have to go for a gem or place sentries in the lane. So then your supports are even squishier, which makes the Dagon even more effective. It's just such a nice item to get, especially on the solo mid Nyx where you can actually farm it. If you're ahead, it's a devastating pickup.
Well, talking about pickups, they're about to get the Aegis here, uncontested. Absolutely no vision Orange has of this going on, and even if they did, well, I guess they'd have to contest it, but... I don't know. Looking at Nyx, if you look at the utility of what he's got the gem, he's got a blink dagger, he's got Dagons. I mean, you know, he can do, and all his spells as it is are pretty crazy. Now they're going to look for a fight, surely. Aegis on Lifestealer. Sorry, not on Lifestealer. They gave it to Luna, of course. I think that Neo.Int are going to need to push for a fight and then push for a wreck. I really do. Because as we know, PL, you don't want him getting crazy. They've got an advantage now. They need to make the most of it.
Yeah, speaking of that PL, he's got the Vitality Booster. The Heart's coming soon, but Heart is not really a catch-all. Oh, they're going to go in on Lifestealer here. I don't know about this.
Disruption just saves him from I think he would have been okay anyway. He's going to just go whale on his tower.
You really have to catch more than one. That was a bad RP for Mushi. Just trying to thought that they could maybe burst the lifestore down, but especially with the PL not being there, you're not killing him without the PL. There's just no way. That was some big miscommunication. Oh, it's a lifestealer bomb. It's a Nyx instead of a Nyx. A Nyx on a Nyx.
It's terrifying.
And he's just
waiting. It's terrifying. As if a giant cockroach that shoots laser beams from his eyes with a dick on isn't bad enough. He's got a zombie inside him.
Oh boy, you're too much. Here we go. The zombie gonna pop out. And look at this easy, easy kill. They did dive really far for that. That's a gem on the ground. They were not able to deny it. SK picks it up. Eclipse comes out. That might have been a wasted Eclipse. But there's no RP. There's no RP, so there's just no way to defend this. Mushi. I mean...
Meanwhile, he's pushing their base, or he's going for their axe. He's just put illusions there. He's going to TP back. I think he realizes we have to defend this.
He can't do this in time. BKB comes out on the Luna, just trying to muscle down the racks.
And I think they might have to back.
There is a lot of spam. But And the one thing is, the mech is on cooldown right now. They don't have any urn charges, so it's a little bit harder to heal up. Good thing that this is...
Whiffed.
Yeah, skewer doesn't affect magic immune units, so as soon as he uses rage, even if you skewer through him, it doesn't move him. Just in time for play.
Yeah, sorry. That was nice timing then from the Nyx.
They may just go for this. This is such a good opportunity, but now RP is actually back up again. No. Round two.
I mean, cooldown on it is crazy. They know if they get three guys, if they get a couple of guys going to Nice Spot, they're going to follow up. Oh, wow, that was big. Nyx is down.
Now they have to run. They cannot fight. There's RP. Nyx is down. You got to get out of here.
I think he manned up too much.
Mushi. He wants this Luna. Oh! He got zapped.
Death slide.
He
still has mages, don't forget.
Mushi underestimated the burst damage of these supports. He really overextended there. He will buy back. He's coming in with the RP. He is going to cancel it. He hasn't cast it yet, even though it looked like he did. The Aegis is coming out. Lifestealer bought back as well.
Ice Path catches it. I think they're going to get it, no problem here.
Oh, he whiffs the RP after canceling it like 30 times. Oh, Mushi. Boy. Period. I don't know if you saw the games yesterday, but there was another mag who kept on missing his RPs. And Mushi hasn't entirely missed his, but they have not been the kind of RPs you need. When you pick this turtle lineup, you count on your mag to hit big RPs and defend the base.
Yeah, you really do. And yeah, they've got this tower now. I mean, once you get Luna in there amongst the barracks, she just whittles them down in like 2 seconds. So yeah, they're going to lose one hit.
Neo.Int, very, very impressive. And there's an Infest, dodges a lot of stuff, and now goes in on Extinct, who burst strikes forward into his demise.
Oh, well, now down goes Arax. Layers in there, having a whale of a time.
There's some he doesn't even need the dagger. This is it. This is GG.
I back from Sand King, but I don't really think that Jakiro, Sand King, and Weaver can defend against this. This is,
This really should be GG. It's possible to throw from this point, but... RP is still on cooldown for 40 seconds. You should easily be able to get two lanes of racks with no glyph being up. And then you're down two lanes of racks against the Nyx with a blink dagger. You can't leave the base. You can't push out of the base very easily. There's just no way out at this point for Orange unless neolution.int makes a horrible blunder and they're not.
No. Jakiro's gonna melt. Yeah, there's the GG. That's a good first game.
There's two stories of this game. The solo mids. Mushi... by far the more accomplished and experienced player, but known more for playing those semi-carry. He plays the Initiator's hero, and this game was just no match for the Nyx, who set up kills all over the place. Check the final score, 8-1 and 10 on that Nyx, but his presence was felt a lot more than his score. The early gem that he was roaming around with, the blink dagger, making that clutch kill on the PL top lane with the blink into the impale, right as he doppelwalk. You can't ask for more from your solo mid, and... normally we see Nyx as a support, but this just shows the versatility of the hero. You can run him solo mid, and he can absolutely crush your team.
He's a great hero. That's why he's like first pick or first ban a lot of the time now. I think, he's ridiculous.
It's the Nyx show. It's a Nyx on a Nyx on a plane. It's actually a Luna on a Nyx right now. So, Pyrian, that is going to wrap it up for this game. It is a best out of three in the SCA League. What do you think going into game two? I have one prediction.
Go on.
There will be no Nyx.
Nyx banned. Yeah, I think that's a safe assumption right there. Yeah, I mean, I think that, you know, Orange are a very good team. Obviously, they're going to obviously as Neo.Int are. So I don't know. They're gonna come up with a plan. I think it's interesting when you see a hero crush like that. They have to go and go back to the drawing board and come up with a different plan. But it's going to be interesting to see who gets picked and banned in the next game.
I gotta say, I just feel Mushi is more comfortable and more in his element on those carries, on those heroes that scale, like Quetopayan, like TA, even the hard carries like the Anti-Mage, the Void. Unfortunately, Ohio isn't here, and he's their normal solo mid player. I believe they just don't want to put the pressure of being that mid in, so he's getting the safe lane farm, and it's probably something he's more comfortable with, Kachik Imba. But we are not going to have the game end, apparently. Well, Bruno can get the stats elsewhere because there is the API now. So, ladies and gentlemen, that wraps it up for game number one.